About the Adam alayhi salam, when he sinned and when he walked out and he saw on the clouds, on the sky was written, La ilaha illallah, Rasulullah was an authentic hadith. This is a very popular hadith, like many people have a misconception. And this hadith is being found mostly into the Sufi books. It's not something found by like an authentic where they have like filtered out the Sahih hadith. The hadith of something like, what was the hadith actually? When the Adam alayhi salam sinned, he walked out and he saw on the sky and it was written, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. And he made this according to the hadith of the Sufism books where they found this hadith. And the Adam alayhi salam, he saw on the sky and it was written, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. And Adam alayhi salam made a dua that, oh ya Allah, I give you, please forgive me for the sake of Muhammad Rasulullah. So Allah asked Adam alayhi salam, how do you know Muhammad? And Adam alayhi salam answered, Allah, that when he walked out, he saw something on the sky was written, La ilaha illallah Rasulullah. It was right next to your name. So that made me think like someone was very beloved to you, and for sake of him, you're going to forgive me. But this is a fabricated hadith. It does not exist in authentic sources of hadith. This is totally fabricated. It doesn't even make any sense, because this is something like a contradicting a Quran. Because in the Quran, where when Allah says, when Adam alayhi salam sinned, he made the dua to Allah. The dua was, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, rabbana zalamna anfusana wa illam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna minal khasirin. Oh Allah, we have did the zulm on ourselves. Oh please, ya Allah, you forgive us. He did not say that I gave for the sake of Muhammad or for the sake of anyone, but rather this hadith was fabricated, doesn't exist. And also, like many sect in Islam, when they make a dua, they make a similar dua. Oh ya Allah, for the sake of Muhammad, please forgive me. Oh ya Allah, for the sake of like Buzurg or the Aliyah, please forgive me. Making this type of dua is a kufr, because Allah created us and we belong to Allah. And when we make a dua, we have to ask Allah directly, Rabbana, because that's what the Adam alayhi salam made the dua, Rabbana. Because if you look at who is Adam? Adam is the first person who was created by Allah. So the Adam alayhi salam did not give the wasila of anybody else, but rather he said, Rabbana zalamna anfusana. Oh ya Allah, I am the one who is a wrongdoer. And you are the one who is a forgiving, and you are the one who is merciful. So please forgive us. If you do not forgive us, and we're going to be go astray. So this type of hadith is a fabricated, and those people making a dua, it's a kufr. It's not allowed to make. It's a haram to make a dua. Whenever you make a dua, give the wasila of the names of Allah. Oh Allah, I gave you for the sake of your name. I give you for the sake of your kingdom. I give the for sake of your beautiful name, for the sake of your power, for the sake of you, for the sake of your izzah, for the sake of yourself. Please forgive me. I do not making a dua of anyone else. Either it's Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam or it's anyone, it's a kufr. It's not allowed to make. It's a haram to make a dua for taking up seal of anyone. Because if you go back to the Adam alayhi salam, the story of the Adam alayhi salam, he made the dua, Rabbana zalamna anfusana. Oh ya Allah, I'm the one who's a wrongdoer. I'm the one who's a wrongdoer, and you are the one who's forgiving to me. If you do not forgive me, I'm going to the one among the ashtray.